Hi, this is me again. I just wanted to talk a little today, about the impact that we can have on other people. I suffered a pretty traumatic experience as a child. I suffered a couple of pretty traumatic experiences as an adult. I can take those experiences and I can wallow in self-pity. I can be depressed, which I've gone through my share of depression, and wallowing in self-pity. But at some point, you have to be thankful for the fact that you're alive. Because of the life that I had the occasion to live, I for a long time didn't believe in God. I didn't understand how a God could do all of the things that he did in the past and not do anything now. I didn't understand how a God could allow babies to be beaten to death, how he could allow a 14-year-old child to have her father's child. I didn't understand how a God that was so loving could allow all of these things to happen. And then I came to realize, some different things about religion, and about spirituality, but a friend of mine said to me one day, "Would you rather exist or not exist?" And I was at a down point in my life, and so I said, "Oh, I'd rather not be here, blah, blah, blah." And he said to me, "No, really think about that question. Would you rather to have never existed at all? To never have smelled and touched and felt and seen and heard and experienced, or to never have done any of those things?" And he said that to me, and I thought about it for a while, and I thought, I would rather have existed than not existed, regardless of all the bad things that may have happened. And he said to me, "God is he that gives you the privilege to exist." And so at that point in my life, I did begin to believe in God again. I'm not Baptist or Christian or Muslim or Jewish or Catholic or Pentecostal or whatever. I believe in God. And I believe that God creates a path for us, a path that he knows about. And there's nothing that happens on that path that we can't in some way deal with. I've been involved in a couple of car accidents. And there was one accident in particular about 6 or 7 years ago. And I almost died. I really probably should have died. I didn't, obviously. And it was almost as if an angel had picked me up in her hand and held me just right there and then set me back down. And I decided at that point that there was something I was supposed to do with my life. I don't know what it is. If I can help touch one person, if I can help you to understand that abuse isn't your fault, but what you choose to do after the abuse is your responsibility. Life happens to everybody. A lot of times, life really, really sucks for a lot of people. Sometimes it may feel like you're the only one in the world that life sucks for. But I read a book a little while back that my friend's 95-year-old grandmother suggested that I read. And it's about a woman in Rwanda who was a part of the Rwandan genocide. She lost her entire family. And for 97 days, I believe, she lived in a bathroom that was large enough for a toilet and a stand-up bath shower stall. And she lived in that room with seven other women. And she listened to the death of her brother occur outside the window. And she heard the Janjaweed looking for her, calling her name. And she survived. And she still loves. And God is a huge part of her life. And so whatever it is that has happened to me and to you, one thing that you have to kind of keep in mind, it's a little morbid, but something worse has happened to someone else. So it helps, at least when I think of that, in respect to the sexual abuse by my father, the sexual abuse by my brother, the alcoholism of my mother, the time at 20 that I was carjacked and raped and thought I was going to be killed. All of these things that have happened to me in my life were bad. But when I realized that in the scope of things, it wasn't as bad as it could have been. It helps me to deal with it a little bit more. Almost, you know, like the saying is, misery loves company. And I think it's kind of nice, not nice, but I can't think of the right word. Comforting to know that somebody else has it worse. But also kind of a reality check that somebody has it worse, and somebody has it worse right now. And somebody doesn't have anybody to talk to right now. And I want you to know that I pray for you every night, that you can find that person to talk to tell your story, to make it stop. But at some point, you gotta remember that your life will become your responsibility if it isn't already. And if you're at an age where you know how to go to the YouTube and to watch the videos, then you're probably at an age where it's time to begin taking responsibility for your own life. And yes, you were abused, or you had an alcoholic parent, or somebody died and you were left alone to take over for your family. Whatever it is, you are now the keeper of your destiny. Nobody else can do that for you. So talk, go to therapy, talk to friends, live your life, be aware of what you do, because as a victim of physical, emotional, or sexual child abuse, you become stinted, and you don't know a lot of the things that you should have learned. So be careful. That's all for today. My time is up. Thank you. Bye-bye.